Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Oklahoma Memorial Stadium in Norman is the venue for today's game, and this should be a good one.
OU wins the toss. How do we get there? Return.
Oh, as we've all said, how he wants it. And we're just about ready to kick this game off, folks. And there's the opening kick of the season.
Bring it out.
He's to the 10. And down he goes at the 19. The Sooners have a new head man. New theories, new hopes, new dreams. Will there be new wins? We'll find out. The quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive.
Three down, three down.
Check 59. Mike is 59. Mike is 59.
288. 288.
Trevor Knight. To start the season as quarterback.
Scrambling around.
He's gonna go deep on his first play. Yes, Neal caught it.
And down he goes, around the 26-yard line.
That's just a great call by the coordinator there, going to the air on first down.
Will we see Marine get a carry?
From the 26-yard line. First down.
The Heisman hopefuls coming in this year. Here he is.
There he goes. Makes it out to about the 16. And that was an excellent run there.
Yeah, Bradford was also great blocking up front by the offensive line to open up the hole.
They'll spread the field with five wide. Now he's scrambling.
Better run it.
Now he's gonna run and watch out. He's pushed out of bounds around the 10-yard line. Knight gains about 6 yards on the scramble. Second down, 4 yards to go. 10 yards to the end zone.
Green feasting in there for the touchdown. His first of the year.
Point. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
The Hurricanes were ranked 21st. Now they hope just to hold on to a spot in the poll. This one was tight. The Owls win it by one.
Thanks, Reese. 7-0 game here. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. Makes it out to maybe the 19-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it.
There we go, Atkins first play. Hold on to Williams over the middle.
Got a man, watch out here.
Almost the first down.
Around the 29-yard line.
Number 19 makes the tackle. 29-yard line. That brings up second and one.
Throws this one away.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down or take off and run with it.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Yeah, that's another. That was tipped and almost picked. Almost caught, too.
And that'll bring up a punting situation.
Fourth and one.
Great hold by the defense. They were expecting the pass play, and they
defended
it very
right
well.
Now.
Hall is waiting for the snap.
There's Sterling Shepard.
Tackle at the 36.
Decent effort. He's not the type of guy to call a fair catch very often. He does have the ability to make guys miss.
They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
As long as this quarterback has time to throw, then you can guarantee that he'll find the open man.
Nice punt, Green.
On the move, throws complete to the tailback. He's tackled at the 33. This quarterback doesn't seem to be having any trouble with the zone, does he?
He recognized the receiver was behind the coverage, and he found him with a perfect strike. That's nice passing for a first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. Oklahoma is up a score.
Nice, opening in, and scramble.
He's going to try and scramble.
Fired over the middle, and it's going to be almost picked.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Quick knockdown.
It falls incomplete. Third down, and they need to get it to the 23.
In. I can't get it off, and we're going to have to do a kick from a rookie kicker.
Getting after that quarterback, and right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet.
Oh, we're
going
to see a punt.
To be a bit rattled.
Bob's rally, whatever, calling a timeout. Be a 50-yarder for your rookie kicker.
Oklahoma is hoping to make this a two-score game.
And he's going to burn another timeout. They're going to go for it. Don't quite trust him yet. I hope we get 10 yards here.
So they're going to go for it here.
That one is caught by Shepard, first down.
And he tackles hard at the 16-yard line.
Gonna waste a few timeouts. I don't know if that's the rookie coach or what. Taking a while to make the right decision.
Oklahoma is up by a touchdown.
Green.
And he carries the ball for a nice gain. The tailback picks up a solid 7 yards on the counterplay. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down.
Westbrook got the first down.
Tackle made at the 6-yard line. Westbrook picks up about 3 with that catch.
Man, that's another first down on this drive. They've looked really good since they came out on the field.
And this is
and
the senior
growing this option. Piron. He's in there for a second touchdown of the game.
Once Once again, he finds the end zone. That's his second rushing touchdown of the game.
This guy has great vision out of the backfield. Even if a hole isn't there, he's patient enough to wait for one to open, and then he hits it.
And he converts the extra point. An 8-play, 65-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. So the score now, 14-0. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff.
Oklahoma looking pretty strong here.
He just drills this one.
Early on.
He's taken down at the 15. The Sooners really took care of business on defense that first time out, Perfect.
One of the great traditions of college football is this defense and the way they play with such passion and enthusiasm in this environment. We're seeing that again today.
They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. Throws it in a hurry. Brought down at about the 25-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
Oh, look at him.
He scrambles.
He's going to run.
And he's got room to work.
He'll get a first down here. He was hurt.
Hey, sometimes the defense does everything right.
Sacrifices
and they still
health
lose.
For a first
that time
down.
They had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the
gotta
quarterback
get
to take off.
Going here. Here comes the backup, number 9.
From their own 41-yard line. First down. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals.
Chapman.
The ball here and brought down in the backfield.
Defense had that one called perfectly. That's a big play on that loss.
The Zips quarterback, we saw him taken out earlier down there on the sideline after being injured. I don't think he's in that much pain right now, though. I would bet that he'll be back in the game before the day's done. As we expected,
yeah,
coming into
the first quarter
this
already
appears to be under control. 14-0 Oklahoma. Second and 14. Ball on the 37.
That's Hungley.
There's a strike complete, and they make the stop at the 41-yard line.
Oregon up 21-3 early. That's deep, and it's caught by Davis. He could go all the way. No.
Got it to the senior. They'll bring him down around the 8-yard line.
Well, you give up too many passes like that, and the game will be done before you know it. It cannot let these receivers
get going no huddle already. And hands it off to Hunley.
He gets out to about the 6-yard line.
That's caught for a touchdown.
Throws quickly into the end zone, caught for the touchdown.
The backup quarterback marches down the field. So the injury was for something at least.
Of the type of chemistry that these two players
starting
enjoy.
Quarterback out.
A quarterback and a receiver on the same page, good things tend to happen.
Chapman comes in after they may have a new quarterback.
A 7-play, 84-yard drive, and they get it in for 7.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. But the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
There's Ross. Nothing.
Tackle made at the 13. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Oklahoma is up 7.
Mike's looking for someone.
He's on the run.
He's going to run it.
Pressure coming.
He's dragged down 8 yards.
At about the 21. second down and about 2 yards to go.
Okay. Second and two. Mike's gonna scramble. He may run. He's not going anywhere.
He's under pressure, and he's sacked.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
From their own 15-yard line, it's third down.
Third and eight now. And he's going to go deep. That's Shepherd wide open. And I don't think anybody can catch him. Oklahoma.
That last catch gives him 100 yards receiving.
Well, Brad, this guy continues to make play after play. The quarterback and this receiver clearly in a zone, feeling it today.
Well, we've still got time left here in the second quarter, so this kid could really end up with a big game. He makes the PAT with a three-play, 86-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
You know, you always prepare your offense to think that we're going to have some success. These guys kind of come over the sidelines after touchdown, saying, man, I didn't expect it to be this easy.
Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
And now we're all facing that. And I think it is, obviously, going to be very, very serious.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead. And on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it.
Unleash running, he got through that line.
He's to the 40. And he's taken down at the 49.
Indiana lost to the FCS team. Illinois lost to the FCS team. Wake Forest barely got by an FCS team.
Fires that quickly, incomplete.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 49. Now he tries to buy some time. He's taken down at about the 45.
Quarterback's back in the game now. Can't remember his name. Roll. He likes to roll. He likes to roll to the left sometimes. He went to the right last time and got injured. Pole is nailed.
Sack him. The pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball
to stay in this game.
From the 28-yard line, second down.
And that's caught by Means Jr. for a first down.
And down he goes at the 16.
After not going away, if they can stick around, they might have a chance.
Nice pass for the first down.
Sooners bringing the blitz on this one. That'd be a dangerous play.
A short yardage defense here.
And that's Cole throws it to the cameraman.
And he just gets rid of it.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
From the 16-yard line, second down.
Whoa.
And he's tackled right away.
Mm-hmm. Big play from Akron here. He's wide open, but he can't even. Oh, he got the first down at least. Should have had a touchdown.
Again, it's the receiver who makes the catch.
If there would have been making doubt as to who's going to be getting the ball before, he's way up the field. Right now.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
It's Hunley, and he's in for a touchdown.
Touchdown, Zips. Strong run by the halfback to get into the end zone.
He's a pretty sure bet to get six when you're this close to the end zone.
Larry Peterson, being the only person on the field with like 11 candidates, who would be called radical just because 50 years ago he'd be called middle of the road.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A 10 play, 75 yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Ross
from the two.
You know, you trying to score before halftime. We don't want to let Akron stick around here.
And through two quarters, everything's working, Herbie, but
rookie coach will go for the jugular here.
Well, you want to keep pushing.
Stay safe. He's off to a great
start. This offense is obviously off to a great start. It's a four-quarter game, and you know the opponent's going to try to get back into this game.
So, this running back is smart. Sidelines.
Himself, his offensive line, and the entire
there.
Continue to try to put more points.
They'll use their last time out. They had those other ones now.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down. Oklahoma up 7 points.
This night, you find Shepard.
And he's tackled at the 43-yard line.
And that's quick. He's wide open. And he's down at the one.
He's tackled right around the 2 yard line.
They're going to have to hurry. Let's see this. Another key run touchdown. If they don't get this with a run, they're not going to get it. So, this is a big gamble. They run it. And P-Ron's in.
Touchdown, OU.
His third touchdown already.
Play 76-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense is looking more and more explosive.
Just squib. That's William. Pretty decent field position for the Akron Zips.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out in the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the
Only goes nowhere. Akron's going to call timeout.
They start to get a little bit fatigued.
Akron will have one timeout remaining. From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. Let's see if a quarterback heaves it up there and one of his guys can come down with it. He goes downtown. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. Well, we've played a half of football. The Sooners lead it by two touchdowns.
Because this is what they do to people in public school. They don't let them.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
He's Davis, David Pollock here in the studio. We're just kicking it off in Akron. Stay in here. They get blown out of the building now.
This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency.
And the State lost to the FCS team.
They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Throws complete. He's got space to work. Tackle made at the 31. That'll make it second and four. Throws it out right to the running back. Brought down at the 32-yard line.
That's a fumble. That's recovered by Thomas. Can he stay on his feet? He does, but he goes out of bounds.
They worked on ripping the ball away all week in practice.
Now,
he got a hand in there and just knocked it free.
Oklahoma can go for the blood.
Signs have made their way back out, and we're just about set to get going again.
E. Ryan again. East is way to a first down.
What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Down, and they've got their eyes on that goal.
Didn't have a lot of yards, but he's got three touchdowns.
They line up in the jumbo set.
And possibly a fourth right here. Got it.
Touchdown, Sooners. The defense hasn't been able to keep this guy from the end zone. He's got four scores.
We wondered if the linebackers were going to be able to slow him down today, and I guess that answer is pretty simple. No.
And he converts the extra point.
What do you do now if you're Akron? Going to panic mode?
He just drills this one.
He's Bickley won't get a chance.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Well, they got to score quick.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Oh, with all the time in the world, but it ran out on him.
In a hurry, and he hits him hard at the 17-yard line.
We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation.
There's Hunley.
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 29-yard line. Get to that quickly. Tackle at the 37. He goes out of bounds, right around the 40.
Thank you. Davis. First down grab by the receiver. Akron trying to stay in it. And I say that because it'd be really easy for him to give up right now. And that's almost, it is picked off by Austin. Austin has got a chance. He's got it. He did it. Cole had a chance at him. Cole pissed. This one was tipped. And then picked. And they reviewed that. They thought it might have hit the ground. Coaches livid for Akron. And there is the review here. Akron thinks it hit the ground. And that is close. Yeah, it might have hit the ground. That's close.
I think this one could go either way.
There's the tip, and there's... Can't tell that angle. Enough to overturn it.
So the ruling's upheld.
It is not enough evidence to overturn.
Oklahoma looking to add to this big lead here. And he adds the extra point.
Excuse me.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Akron's having a hard time doing anything on offense right now.
Well, they've had some opportunities, but they either turn the ball over or obviously don't execute on third down and they're forced to punt. Or their drive ends up stalling in a fourth down. But they're moving the ball at times. I think they've just got to take some chances at this point late in the game.
And Sanchez fell down on that one. He could have possibly taken it to the house. He would have been up. Hole is hit by Sanchez this time and makes up for it. He just looks at him. Nobody there to block.
From their own 28-yard line. Third down.
This quarterback is tough as nails, Brad. He's going to sit in that pocket and give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
Paul awaits the snap. At the corner. He's tackled at the 49. Quarterback leads the offense back out onto the field as we get set to resume play. Oklahoma comes to the line. They got a big advantage in this one. They'll bring him down around the 46-yard line.
Well, you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
So it's second and 13. Ball on the 46. On the ground, inside. That's a great tackle at the 40-yard line.
I don't think the play developed the way it was supposed to, and the net result is a loss.
That's three down and one to go. Oklahoma's running away with it.
Organic that they're supplying some of these big stores. It is organic. It's just low levels of it. They're only one thing. This all together is just absolutely awesome.
Well, folks, we resume action here in the fourth quarter. We'll hope for some action because so far it's been a lopsided one. They're packed in tight on the line.
Erine. Trying to add some yards to his other total.
This game's been over for a long time. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. The deficit is huge, but as a player, you never want to slow down your effort. Believe me, coaches notice the ones who aren't trying that hard. And he's taken down right around the 34. He's taken down at the 44-yard line. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Complete. He's got room. And he is drilled at the 48. He's at the 30, and they finally push him out at the 27. He's got 100 yards in the game now.
You gotta love this quarterback receiver combo. Talking to these guys before the game, they told me they spend about an hour after every practice perfecting the routes. It sure shows.
On the defense, not living up to the task of just burying this team. They need him.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves.
Give Piron another chance to add some yards. To help his Heisman chances. And they're going for that for him this year. Not all about winning for OU right now.
Caught with room to work. He gets hit out of bounds at the 23.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
That could have been picked.
Almost intercepted there.
Had it in his hands. He's already looking the support center for the highlights.
And he just dropped it. A quarterback in the gun with five receivers.
And is he having a tough time with an FCS team? And that's a good one. He's nailed. Notre Dame with a pretty good showing there.
A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
That's a touchdown.
Zips it to his receiver. Touchdown.
What happened here?
He stepped up and threw a touchdown pass to his wideout.
Good job of protection.
For a few mental mistakes. Too much fate in this game.
And he tacks on the extra point.
Few turnovers with a different series.
Brad, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with
they're gonna try to get the onside kick. The Palma not in the onside recovery position.
Well, this is strange. The kicking
and that is out of bounds to the stands.
But the return team's in their normal kick return formation.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
So the offense will take over with pretty good field position.
The onside kick just wasn't successful there. The kicker really didn't give his guys a chance to make a play.
Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop.
Ryan.
On the run. Room around the corner. Good outside run there. Second and six coming up here. Ball on the 41.
Ryan with another first down.
He makes his way to about the
32. Don't know his total yards yet. Looking with the stat monkey back in the back. Try to figure that out. Ryan feasting over the another first down.
Gains his way to the 20-yard line. From the 20-yard line, it's first down. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter.
There he is again. Nothing there.
They'll drop him for a loss.
Shepherd over the middle. Can't get a first down.
He's got his man, and he's tackled right around the 12-yard line. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go.
Ryan, close to a first down, fourth and inches. They're going to give it to P. Ryan, try to get this last yard. And this is Ross in there. And Ross do anything. Ross! They're going to call a timeout. Try to get P. Ryan another touchdown. You might call this unsportsmanlike. Probably true. You got a young man trying to get a Heisman from the get-go. And he's going to get close. And they'll call another timeout.
Oklahoma's going to have to use their second timeout of the half.
He's going
to
get some heat from this in the news this week. Count on that. Well, the Heisman voters look at this. P. Ryan can't get it. When they call the last timeout, if he doesn't get this, then that could look really bad. It's all about P. Ryan touchdowns, and it's not about them scoring. But we won't see any play actions. And here he is. He got it. His fifth touchdown. Not a very sportsmanlike move there by anyone. And that'll do it, 49-21.
He splits the uprights with the extra point.
We'll be back later on today with Oklahoma State's first game of the year.
Hoping a big win would send them soaring
we'll
up the
ranks. On that game later.
And for Virginia Tech, here's a team trying to win the first game of the year. The Hokies lead 7-0. Today we saw a game that wasn't even close.
Line.
Oklahoma 49, Akron 21.
What he ended up with yard-wise, maybe 60 yards, I would think.
That wraps things up.
Five touchdowns.
3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.
There's the play of Shepherd or wide open. Thank you. We'll get to see. Yards, five touchdowns. See you later.